Last time we solved the puzzle, which I way overcomplicated for myself, I just assumed that I needed two keys, but I only needed one. With you, we can cause an everlasting night upon our adversaries, thereby preventing them from replenishing their energy from the sun. That is one of the reasons we need you. The other shall be revealed when the need arises after the hospital. Okay, don't do that. Okay, what is with all of these random, just like, planes? Just flat planes. Just... I don't know. Ow. I kind of think that maybe those flat planes are supposed to be like low LED tree foliage or something. It just glitched out. But like, Horror Tales the Wine didn't have any of these issues as far as I remember. I don't know what's going on. Well, that's, no idea. Wait, was there? Oh, that's all. Okay, that's definitely going to be. I need to make it noon. Or something. Probably noon. Sun A, Sun B, Sun C. Really? Oh, right, solar panels. So the solar panels, powering that, that's powering that, that's powering. To be able to I saw that shadow. I don't like that shadow. What? like this. Why is the wheelchair stuck in the ground? I don't know. I don't know if that's supposed to happen, or if that's a glitch. Neither would particularly surprise me. I think it's a glitch, though. That's not gonna work. Okay. Now, that's hitting some kind of invisible barrier here. Hello. shocked me. Oh, this is the way back up in case you fall through. I gotcha. Sorry, my voice is like cracking because I am just like, I hate horror. I hate it. Why do I do this to myself? You know, one of these bodies is just going to suddenly like get up, right? If that doesn't happen, I will be so surprised. Yeah, it's trying to be all cute. I don't trust it. I don't trust cute. From other side, all one word. You know, you're the one who literally tried to kill me before I did anything, so... Also, that was super creepy the way it was just, like, slowly walking after me. One sec. No power, stop. I wonder if I could have done this without. But I don't know. Somehow I doubt it. Oh my gosh. The animation is so... I mean, that's gotta be it, right? That's cool, we can swim. That's something you couldn't do in Horror Tales of the Wine. What's this? The dangerous wine trip arrives in Russia. The wine trip fad that emerged in the United States among the children of the filthy rich has finally reached Russia. The practice of the wine trip consists of a level up after obtaining bottles of toxic Benedobosk wine for astronomical prices and ingesting it in a controlled manner to promote new neural connections after overcoming deadly hallucinations. This practice began to spread since Xavier Roeg's team showed the world that the ingestion of large quantities of metallic moss trapped in the wine creates after the hallucinations reinforced neural connections in tune with the Earth's own magnetic field. Okay. Roeg's team believes it is possible to create neural connections between humans and CPUs efficiently thanks to this. Okay. I think that's probably the biometal. The United Nations is expected to ban this practice until the lab test by Roeg and his team, whose work is still in the preliminary stages, are completed. Okay, I can't jump across that. I don't think. Well, that wasn't even a jump. That was a meh. There we go, see? This is really difficult. And this helps me... how we first came in here. Now what? Can't pick up water. Say what? Say what? Since when? I'm so confused. When did we get... There was not a single reference to weather, and now all of a sudden... Now all of a sudden we can control weather. Randomly. No explanation. Okay, I was... Try moving water particles in the air to cause huge storms that will flood everything. Upon our arrival at the subterranean laboratory beneath the skyscrapers and your subsequent healing, we shall employ this ability to corrode the ranks of the biometal hordes. Okay. But you already gave me that okay. I think that was a bug. I don't think we were supposed to be able to get that ability yet. Wow, this doesn't make any sense. Thank you. Oh. It's literally... Well, I'm very confused. I'm pretty sure I butchered that somehow. But the continuity here doesn't make sense, but I have observed that your hallucinations and Morven tend to diminish beneath the clarity of the skies. Oh. Should you encounter difficulties amid misty conditions, consider dispersing the haze. Naturally, this will also facilitate more effective monitoring on my part. The fog... The fog makes your hallucinations invincible to damage. I'm crying. Use your powers to clear the skies and be able to damage the hallucinations when the fog sets in. I think you mean hallucinations. You want to bet? This is a combat area. There's so many things on the ground. I was hoping the rain would put out the fire. But it didn't. Let's make it sunset. I mean, isn't this obviously just going to turn into combat? Genuinely? Why can we not run? Like, seriously? Also, why are you doing that to me? Why are you... Really, dude? Oh, right. I was like, who's hitting me? No, I was just damaging myself. Attack me or not? I'm sorry, I'm not taking the chance. Confused. There was something more to this, wasn't there? Okay, now this is where I came down from. So yeah, I think we just go through there.
The beggar managed to screw himself. Use your neck to look up beggar. The beggar trapping himself here was not part of the plan. The beggar can't progress sends my assistance. Seeking a solution to unscrew the beggar. Electric solution found.
Okay.
The beggar is a fortunate bastard. I completed the other task and came here just 3 minutes ago.
Oh, is this going to be another one of those? Yes, it is. Yeah, I think there's a... Yeah, there's a wall there. I don't think you can go that way. Okay. If you can't go that way, then... Which way am I supposed to go? Oh, you know what? Let ourselves heal. The amount of time that you have to spend to charge at this is still just... I don't know. A little annoying, but okay. That's fine. Great, I miss. Oh no, do not tell me. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. I am stuck in an infinite death loop. Why would you respawn? Why would you respawn your character in a death zone? That's just beyond stupid. No. Clear. You can't just cancel it, I guess? No, I was trying to make it noon. I don't know if that has anything to do with the ghosts and whatnot. Monster. I didn't have to do that. Oh, shoot. Whoa, okay. Oh. Okay, would you let me? No. Okay. it. I have literally no idea where I'm supposed to be going. At least it's pretty forgiving with the damage. I just need, like, a reliable source of damage to do to the enemy. You know, like, a barrel. The most pointless thing that you can't just like aim. Oh my gosh. This is just tedious at this point. He can't do enough damage to, like, actually kill me. And but he's moving too fast for me to really be able to aim at him. Thank you. just not. I can't even see what I'm doing. You want to come down here? I can't aim at you in the sky, you know? I literally can't. I have a feeling maybe I'm not even supposed to actually be fighting this dude. But oh my gosh, I cannot hit you to save my life. Good heavens, Betsy. Cannot hit you. Thank you. Where are you? This is... What? I hit something. I think it might have like appeared right at the moment that I released it. Well, that was an annoying one. I feel like there's another one here, though, because... I swear there was two dogs. I swear there was. But maybe not. Okay, where am I supposed to be going? You are here. Maybe there wasn't. Really? Of course it's locked. I'm gonna end this episode here. I wanted to get through this area fully before I ended, but yeah, no. When we come back next time, we'll keep looking for the key or for the way around the door. But anyway, thanks for watching, and we will... That's definitely where we're headed. We'll see you next time.